I definitely still remember my first high school game when I was it was in 1999, and you know, we were playing versus Chicago Falls in Akron, Ohio, and you know, our high school coach kind of just told us, you know, just be patient, you know, don't be afraid to make mistakes, because you guys are freshmen and you will make mistakes, but how do you learn from those mistakes? And you know, play hard, play smart, and have fun. And that's exactly what he did.
The Cleveland Cavaliers select LeBron James.
2003年，詹姆斯这个克利夫兰出生的小伙子，以天才高中生的身份加盟了 NBA。他当时被叫小皇帝，横空出世，一出道即迈入巅峰，成为骑士队的领袖。2003至2010的七个赛季是詹姆斯的 1.0 时代，享受了超级巨星的待遇，也承担着超级巨星的
责任。Arco Arena in Sacramento, the much anticipated debut of one LeBron James.
Get closer and closer to the tip-off. Time to get ready.
National televised game. I couldn't even stretch on the court because I had so many cameras in my face.
Here he comes the other way. There's your first James Jam of his career. Whoa.
第一个一万分就在这个时期，那时詹姆斯每时每刻都在打破联盟各种纪录，直到2008年2月27号，在对阵波士顿凯尔特人比赛中，詹姆斯拿下了他生涯的第一万分，并且他是史上最年轻的一位，还不到24岁。意气风发的小皇帝詹姆斯的到来，也令骑士队开始走出过去几年的沉寂。
First time in the playoffs in I think eight nine years, and we beat Washington.
LeBron to the hoop for the win. He's got it with 9 tenths left. You get booked this one to the Cavaliers.
然而，球队整体实力不行，每每到最后关头，总是功亏一篑。在失败面前，之前的种种赞誉只能让他哭笑不得。
I'm going to take my talents to South Beach and join the Miami Heat.
2010年7月8号，詹姆斯离开骑士，和韦德、波什组成了热火三巨头。伤心的家乡球迷感受到了背叛，他们烧毁了詹姆斯的球衣，媒体也大多是负面报道。从进入联盟就被捧上神坛的詹姆斯又被抛弃，在真正的逆境中，詹姆斯开始学会聆听自己的声音。顶着骂名，他为热火带来了两个总冠军。
Most important game in his career. Let the coronation begin. LeBron James has helped crown Miami a champion of the basketball world.
When you get to know him,
I'm at a loss for words. I'm an NBA champion. Nobody can ever take that away from me.
The back-to-back Miami Heat champions.
总冠军为詹姆斯找到了荣耀，而两万分的荣耀也如期而至。在2013年1月18号，面对还不是超级战舰的勇士，已是卫冕冠军得主的詹姆斯，出场30分钟，拿下25+7+10的数据，轻取勇士，成为最年轻的两万分先生。此时他29岁不到。 2014-15 赛季开始，即将迈过而立之年的詹姆斯重回故乡克利夫兰，因为他想要完成对这里的承诺，他想给这里带来总冠军的荣耀。
Irving fakes, drives, James on the throwdown. He's at the right point. He stutter steps. He launches a three. He nailed it. It's over. The Cavaliers are NBA champions.
This is for you.
这一刻，他完成了自己。一球又一球，在34岁即将到来之时，他的30,000分终于如期而至。
Won a championship. I haven't had a time to really just sit and appreciate and, you know, the journey that I've been on. And I don't want to because I think it's allowed me to stay on the path that I've been on. So.
Welcome to China.
Welcome.
Thank you.
I'm really glad to meet you this time. I think in fact, there is not only an amazing day, but also not amazing energy to you.Because you always play in a long season, just like last year, you played in almost all games. So how you keep yourself, the quality of your training, and keep yourself so effective in the long season?
Yeah, I mean, it's very difficult. Like you said, I mean, I played in every game last year, and I think it's the love of the game that I have. And, you know, I try to keep my body fresh, keep my mind fresh as well.My love for the game just kind of trumps everything, so I'm always looking forward to the next challenge. What is the next challenge? You know, if it's that next game, or if it's the road trip that's coming up, or whatever the case may be, I just love the challenge. And for me to know I was in my 15th season, played in every single game, and never, never hit a wall, it was a tremendous feat for myself.
作为如今的 NBA 现役第一人，詹姆斯上个赛季连续第八年率队打入总决赛，并继续谱写着属于他的传奇，连续得分上双纪录达到873场，历史第一，第三次拿下全明星赛最有价值球员，接连打破科比的 NBA 最年轻30,000分和31,000分纪录，达成常规赛同时得到30,000分、8000个篮板、8000次助攻，历史首人。季后赛总得分6911分，超越乔丹，历史第一。而这些还只是詹姆斯仅仅在上个赛季所创下的记录中的一部分。
And you have mentioned you are a leader. You always be a leader in a game and in a team. So the last year you have achieved amazing date.That's like the 30,000 points and 8,000 rebounds and 8,000 assists. So how do you feel that moment when you achieve the amazing date?
It's a great moment. It's a great moment not only for myself, but, for my family and my friends. And, anytime I'm able to be linked up there with some of the greatest players that ever played the game who've accomplished these feats, like you said, 30,000 points, 8,000 rebounds, 8,000 assists. I think I became the first player in NBA history to ever do that. It's like, wow. It's a wow factor because I've watched the game for so many years and I've seen so many great basketball players. And for me to sit at a point where no one has ever been before, as far as all those three statistical categories, it was like,Wow, I can't believe it.
But to be honest, most of people in China, they are not very surprised that you can reach the amazing date because they are always waiting for you to be the first player in NBA who reached 40,000 points and with 10,000 plus 10.
Oh man, the pressure. A lot of pressure, huh? A lot of pressure, a lot of work.
But I have confidence So do you have confidence to yourself?
Oh, absolutely. Well, as far as to get the 40,000 points, 10,000 assists, 10,000 rebounds, I don't really embark on that, but I'm definitely a confident person. I think everyone has to be confident when it comes to what they do and what they want to do. In order to be really, really good or be great at what you do, you have to be able to look in the mirror and be confident in your ability. So I am extremely confident in my ability, and I'm confident because I know how much work I put into it, how much work I put into my craft, how much training I do, both physically and mentally. So thank you. Thank you to all the China, everyone here in China, my Chinese family. Thank you for even believing in me, and I'm gonna continue to do great things.
今夏，勒布朗·詹姆斯转会湖人，成为 NBA 最重磅的消息。然而，已经33岁的詹姆斯还能够保持巅峰状态多久？他的到来会不会抑制湖人年轻球员的成长？他连续八年进入总决赛的记录是否会在明年终止？这些都为詹姆斯在湖人的前景画上了一个大大的问号。
You know, for me to be in this position now, the excitement that I have to be a Laker, I'm happy to be a part of it because I believe the Lakers is a historical franchise. We all know that, but it's a championship franchise, and that's what we're trying to get back to. And I'm happy to be a part of the culture and be a part of us getting back to that point. So this is where it is today, man.
Yes, so when LeBron plays and the fans here in China said,a record will be broken. So that is the eighth time consecutively you bring your team into the NBA final. So in the new season, so you will do that? And rewriting all this continually?
Yeah, that's the goal.
That's the goal.
That's the goal.
With a new team?
With a new team, young team. You know, we're very new to each other, and that's the goal. But,we know that the road goes through Golden State. We understand that. The whole NBA understands that. But that is always the goal. Each and every year you train and you prepare to try to get to another NBA final. So that is my preparation.
Now, to the new team, what you will bring to them? What champion experience to the young men?
Yeah, I think you said it. I mean, you guys, you know, been preaching it the whole time since we've been doing this interview. And I think for myself,you know, being able to, you know, bring my championship DNA, my championship pedigree, my championship habits to the Lakers franchise and also to the players that's been there.
People always remember whatever it takes, the attitudes.
Yeah.
You have always emphasized in every game with your teammates. And now with the Lakers, and how would you like to share the spirit and with the young teammates over there in the West?
No, I think more importantly than what I need to share with the younger guys, I think what a lot of people are missing are how hungry for knowledge that the young guys have. You know, with Kuz and Zoe and Josh Hart and Brandon Ingram, Kentavious Caldwell-Pope, you know, Slavy and Mo, you know, Wagner. We have...young guys that's extremely excited about not only playing the game but also learning the game too. So that's going to help out even more because those guys are just hungry for knowledge. So we look forward to that.
Maybe from this season, maybe someone will introduce you Lakers LeBron James. To be honest, I can accept the truth until now, but it's the truth.So, about the LA, about the Los Angeles, it's a new start for you and your family. Do they like the city or do you like the city?
It is. It's a new start for me and my family. But we always, you know, we've made change before. You know, we've made change from to go to Miami and we figured that out and had a great time down there and fell in love with the city. And I believe we'll do the same in Los Angeles. We have a lot of friends and family in Los Angeles, you know, so, you know, every day is going to be another opportunity for us to continue to learn what Los Angeles is all about. And, you know, I think it's going to be one heck of a ride.